Hello, I'm Mr. May, and welcome to Sixth Period Music Technology. First of all, I just want to introduce myself. I'm actually the orchestra director, mariachi director, jazz band director here at White Plains High School, and I'm going to be teaching this month for the music technology course. Mr. Davidson started the year and has since gone to another school district under another position, and we've hired a new teacher named Mr. Cassidy that'll be starting at the beginning of November, who is going to do an excellent job in this role, has a lot of experience teaching music technology. But I am actually very delighted to be teaching this class for this month because I have a lot of experience with recording and producing in my own past in a lot of different styles of music. And so I'm very excited to be stepping in, and I'll be able to keep everyone right on pace with the curriculum that we have for this year. So now I'd like to show you, this is our lab. It's a really great addition to the high school. Each station here has a MIDI keyboard, a Mac iMac desktop, a microphone, a digital audio workstation, those are the red boxes that transfer the audio from a microphone into the computer system and then back out through the headphones, maintaining really excellent audio quality. And then the software on the computers includes GarageBand, which is a very accessible, easy to use software, and Logic Pro, which is studio quality professional software. Each day when a few of the students come in, we maintain social distancing and we have huge boxes of disinfecting wipes. So we do clean each station with disinfectant, including the headphones and every surface that gets touched every day. And we usually have at most about 5 students in this room at a time, which gives us well over our 6 feet distance. And then also, I just wanted to share a little bit about some of the things that we're doing. I mentioned GarageBand earlier because GarageBand, the recording software, is easy to use and also has 2 forms, the desktop version and an iPad version. We're actually able to work on it on our iPads from home. So a lot of the same projects that we're working on in class can also be done at home. And I have just an example. This is from the project we did today. This is what GarageBand looks like, one of the screens in iPad form. And we were just programming some beats today. And that work can easily be saved, shared, sent to the desktop computers here at the high school and be expanded upon even more. But people have recorded whole albums on this iPad version of GarageBand. So we really have a lot of tools at our fingertips to explore music technology, even being in and out of the building, how we are in this year's hybrid model. So next I'll go over to just a few bullet points about what's involved in the curriculum, but it's good to see you. Feel free to contact me anytime. I'll have my contact information in the next screen as well. Thank you. Now I'll tell you just a little bit about our curriculum for this year and what to expect over the course of the semester. This is an introductory course, so students with no musical background can learn enough about the basics of making music to be successful, and students with some or quite a bit of musical background can learn enough about the tools of music recording and production to be able to draw on their other knowledge and make creative, large-scale projects. To do this, we are using the equipment that's down in the lab, which includes the desktop computers, MIDI controllers, those are the keyboards, the audio interfaces and microphones, as well as the software GarageBand, Logic Pro, and Audacity that they have on the computers, and GarageBand, which we have on the iPads as well, which allows us to do about 90% of what we do in the lab from anywhere, which is very helpful. Students will learn how to use some of that hardware, the MIDI keyboards, microphones, and how to manipulate audio files within the software that we have using those tools, as well as some music basics. The last month or so of school has been an overview of keyboard skills, piano skills, note reading skills, and those will be able to be used right away in the recording settings in the coming weeks. And it all ties together when we start making projects And every one of these elements, melody, harmony, rhythm, using different tempos, dynamics, modulations, musical forms, all of those items are a part of each project we make as we start making musical choices about what we want to craft our songs into sounding like. Some examples of projects that we're going to be doing soon are composing using loops, which are pre-recorded samples that we can find in GarageBand, creating melodies and rhythms using a MIDI keyboard, creating a beat with found and body percussion sounds, as well as programmable beats that we can create in GarageBand, podcasting, scoring to film, and creating portfolios of work that we do in the class. Some of those projects we've already begun. We've been programming beats this week, and next week we'll be building on those beats to start creating songs with different forms, with different sections that flow into one another. A typical flow of a project this year with our hybrid model begins on Schoology with an introduction of a topic and a video tutorial. Then students do a small project just about a single topic to demonstrate their understanding of how to execute that topic. And then after that, with the time that's left in each class after the specific topic has been addressed, students can work on ongoing creative projects that are going to be able to use multiple tools to create finished products that sound excellent. And we are at the point in the semester where we're starting to gather more and more tools, and very soon the projects are going to start looking longer, more involved, and more finished. The grading policy and expectations are pretty straightforward. 25% of the grade is going to be participation on Zoom, in class, getting projects done in a timely manner, and not being distracted, and also communicating regularly through Zoom or in person, just answering questions and being engaged in the process of learning the music technology. And 75% of the grade will be the projects. There is an assignment Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday of every week, mostly short and doable in one class period or less, and each one of those projects is going to contribute to that 3/4 of the grade that build upon each other and turn into larger projects in the end. Finally, I'm really impressed with meeting everyone and seeing what projects everyone started on so far. I want everyone to keep a positive attitude, keep practicing your skills throughout this class, keep progressing, and hopefully this is going to be a very fun experience learning these new tools and being able to make some great music together this year. Thank you, and I'm looking forward to a great next month and a great semester for the students.